बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम फोर क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, मैम नगीना इज हियर विद एसएसटी लेक्चर, लेक्चर नंबर 22। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आई एम फाइन एंड होपफुली यू आर फाइन टू। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कम ऑन चैप्टर नंबर 11। चैप्टर नेम इज दैट मुस्लिम रूल इन द सबकॉन्टिनेंट। Book reading: Arabs had been trading with the communities on the west coast of the subcontinent even before the coming of Islam. In 570 CE, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born in Mecca in Arabia. In 610, he received the first divine message from Allah and declared the religion of Islam. After many hardships and having to leave his town and move to another city, now known as Medina, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam passed away in 632 CE. By then, Islam had spread throughout Arabia, and in the years that followed, it spread further into Africa, Asia, and the subcontinent, and even in parts of Europe. In 712 CE, the governor of Iraq, Hajjaj, sent his troops with the young commander Muhammad bin Qasim to deal with Raja Dahir, the ruler of Debel in Sindh. Raja Dahir had been unable to control the pirates who had captured his ships carrying goods for the ruler of Iraq and Muslim pilgrims to Mecca. Muhammad bin Qasim not only defeated Raja Dahir but also conquered the lands from the Arabian Sea coast up to Multan in Lower Punjab. He established a strong and just government with good reforms for the people. As a result, many people willingly converted to the new religion. This conquered territory became part of the Arab Empire for the next 200 years. Did you know? A hero is a person who is admired for his courage, outstanding achievements, or noble qualities. We can all have own heroes to look up to and follow. Who do you admire and why? When the Arabs came to the subcontinent, they took many useful ideas from the Indians and spread them to other parts of the world. The most important ideas that spread during this time were the digital numerals and the concept of zero. This brought great change and development in mathematics and science. Table: Arabic numerals, Roman numerals, Arabic numerals, Roman numerals. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Roman numerals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Arabic numerals. 7, 8, 9, 10, 279, 3,364, 944. Roman numerals. V double I, V triple I, IX, X, double C, L, double X, I, X, triple M, triple C, L, X, I, V, C, M, X, L, I, V. By the 10th and 11th centuries, there was a mixture of peoples, languages, and cultures in the subcontinent: Arabic, Persian, Turkish, and Indian. By the end of the 11th century, Muslim rule was firmly established all over this area. Mahmud, the ruler of Ghazni in Afghanistan, was among the early Muslim invaders. From the northwest, he attacked India, many times and destroyed a famous temple in Somnath. However, he did not set up his government in this region but returned to Ghazni with the treasures he had captured. Mahmud ruled from 997 to 1030. This is a peak. The oldest surviving mosque and Mansura. The Delhi Sultanate, all of the northern India up to Bengal, was conquered by the Afghan ruler of Ghor, Muhammad Ghori. In 1192, he made Delhi the capital of his kingdom. Ghori was followed by a long line of Muslim rulers. The first of these was his general Qutbuddin Aibak, who formed the Delhi Sultanate in 1206. Among its rulers were Iltutmish and his brilliant daughter Razia Sultana. The strongest of the Delhi kings was Balban, who ruled from 1246 to 1287. He was also a clever and capable general, and he saved the subcontinent from the attacks of the Mongols led by the famous Chinggis Khan. Balban built strong forts along the routes and stationed his troops there to stop the Mongols from advancing. This is a peak, Somnath. Mahmud's tomb in Ghazni. A tomb in Lodhi Gardens, Delhi. Towards the end of the 13th century, the Khaljis came to power and ruled from 1290 to 1320. Their most well-known ruler was Alauddin. They were followed by the Tughlaqs, 1221 to 98. The Sayyids, 1414 to 51, and the Lodhis, 1451 to 1526. Dear students, these are the short questions. You will write these short questions on your sticky notes and later will be marked on your book. Question number 1, question number 2, 3 and 4. Question number 1. When did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born? See page number 76. Question number 2. When did the Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam pass away? See page number 76. Question number 3. Who was Mahmud? See page number 77. Question number 4. When did Khaljis came into power? See page number 77. Students, now you can mark the answers on your book. Question number 1, Ans. In 570 CE, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born in Makkah in Arabia. It's the answer of short question number 1. Come question number 2. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away in 632 CE. Its answer of short question number 2, from here to here. Come on page number 77. Short question number 3, answer. Mahmud, the ruler of Ghazni in Afghanistan. Its answer of short question number 3, from here to here. Come on question number 4, on page number 77. Towards the end of the 13th century, the Khaljis came to power. Its answer of short question number 4, from here to here. Dear students, this is all about lecture. Learn by heart. Take care. Allah Hafiz.